preseason practice.
I love it.
Last ever.
Last ever. No. Last at Penn State, hopefully. It was good. We've been blessed to have good weather, you know. We've been blessed to have Joe let y'all come out here and videotape us a little bit. I think this is going to be a memorable season, though, so got to document everything, you know. Oh, it's over. Hungry, man. Oh, it's time to play now. It's time to play now. Time to get it on. I can't wait. I'm hungry. Hey, Z. Hey, Z. It's over, baby.
It's the last one,
yeah,
homie.
Yeah.
That's
a crazy
shit.
Good job,
yo.
Good job, good job,
good job.
Y'all stepped
it up
today, yo. Each of us would like to be able to stop time once in a while. When you're young, it's hard to appreciate how fast it disappears. Michael Robinson walked into Beaver Stadium for the first time in his last season. College seniors, by no means old in the grand scheme of things, at least appreciate that fact. Joined by other seniors who realize how little time they have left as collegiate football players. It has consumed their collegiate lives.
About that time, man.
Then there are the kids, the freshmen. The older guys remember, but also wonder, were we ever that young? It takes a blend of youthful enthusiasm and talent to go along with experience to forge a good football team. And appropriately, as Penn State opened the season, youth was served as early as the opening kickoff. Nittany Lion fans got an immediate glimpse of the future as two of the most sought-after recruits in the country, Derek Williams and Justin King, made it fun to consider the possibilities of the next 4 years, which will go by all too quickly.
Williams, flip it back in the reverse to Justin King, near side 30, King 35, 40, King 45, 50, 45, 40, near side 35, 40, Justin King 20, 15, 10, 5, sets, wait, fires downfield, Derek Williams makes the catch at the 49-yard line.
The immediate injection of speed into the offense is just what the doctor ordered, but make no mistake, these Lions are about veteran defense.
And then Belton and fumbles the football, Allen's a minus from the 10 to the 5, touchdown Penn State. Tim Shaw forced the fumble, and Allen Zamitis takes it to the house.
Perhaps no one on this team appreciates time more than Chris Harrell. After an injury nearly ended his career, he's bought himself one more season in the sun and is already making it count, standing out in an opening win over South Florida. Seniors know it's gone in an instant. Freshmen think it will last forever, but if they all make the best of it, the possibilities, like time, truly are endless.
I missed it a lot. Just having to sit back and, you know, watch football for a whole season. That was really tough for me after playing ever since I was little.
They were at the pep rally last night, and you know, a lot of the freshmen were like, "Oh my God, I never seen that many people." And I'm like, "Man, that's nothing." You know, and you know, they might have been a little shell shocked, but they calmed down after the first couple of plays, and I don't think they really can be considered freshmen anymore.
Joe Paterno has always believed that a football team should improve most between its first and second games. His Nittany Lions look sharper everywhere, particularly along the offensive line against Cincinnati. The bright sunlight of a glorious late summer day revealed not only a fundamentally improving team, but one that appears to be coming together as a family, happy for each other's success.
Have a great day today, all right? Great day, all right?
One, two, three.
Goes Robinson, long and deep, Justin King, he just makes the catch at the 2015, 10-5, touchdown, Penn State, 59 yards from Michael Robinson to Justin King, who gets the first touchdown of his Penn State career.
Touchdown makers have always made the headlines, but you can't pile up nearly 400 yards of offense without the guys up front opening holes and protecting the quarterback. While some freshmen tasted the end zone for the first time, so too did an unsung junior, Patrick Hall. The guys up front on defense mirrored their brothers on offense, gladly doing the dirty work in the trenches, to allow the glory to go to linebackers in the secondary.
Back goes Grootsa, and there's Puslowski, who buries him at the 10-yard line.
What they all shared, though, was passion, and it was evident in the way they hit, causing four turnovers and accumulating four sacks. The Bearcats had nowhere to run.
Doing all right, man. Excited to be back out here, man. Had a great week of practice.
A great week of practice that translated into a great week for Penn State and a Michael Robinson-led offense that got some wind in its sails and a lot of air under the football.
Robinson play action again. Set long and deep for Deion Butler near side. Deion at the goal line. He's got it. Touchdown, Penn State.
The fleet-footed freshmen continue to emerge, taking baby steps for now on a team that in the me generation of sports is still glad to give credit to the next guy, even if it takes a while to find him.
I think we played a pretty good football game. Overall, we're not there yet. We got to do some things better, but I think we played about as well as I think we could play at this time of year.
Wide receivers were great today. You know, they just came off the ball. They were beating the corners down the field and, you know, making catches for touchdowns. They looked great.
It was Penn State football. You know, we were able to run the ball early, really grind it out. On defense, we were able to make plays and get turnovers and really be aggressive. That's really one thing that Penn State's really good at, being aggressive and going at teams.
Drop play, Tony Hunt, 50. Side steps from the left, 45, 40. Tony near side, 35, 30, 25, 20. Hunt to the 15, cuts inside to the 10 and down there. Tony Hunt rips off a 39-yard run and a first down. Rolling near side, being chased.
The blocking seemed more precise. The hole seemed a little bigger, and the effort was rewarded.
Good snap to Robinson, play action fake, sets up. Long and deep down the middle for Deion Butler.
Let's go, 1, 2, 3,
ball.
It's a good day, man, good day to play some football.
Their first game ever against Central Michigan was also Penn State's last game before the Big Ten season. And it was a very good day. The extra push was evident.
Smith back to pass, pressure, Rice chases, Rice throws it down at the 30-yard line.
The emotion was tangible. The last weekend of the summer, perhaps a view into the autumn.
Shotgun Robinson, play action fake, Mike sets. Throws it for Butler at the 5, goal line, touchdown, Penn State. Robinson rolls near side, delivers it long and deep for a wide open Terrell Golden at the 10, the 5, touchdown, Penn State. 3 more touchdown passes for Michael Robinson.
This was not about beating Central Michigan 40-3. It was about a team starting to believe in themselves because of their leader. Was always believed in them. The Big Ten season is now in their hands.
The offense we face today, Northwestern does a lot of the same things. So, you know, I think we're really looking forward to it. You know, we're coming in 3-0, you know, three good wins, three solid wins for us, and that we're just really excited.
I think if you just play football, if you go out there and you hustle every day, I don't care where you play, you're going to learn. You're going to learn something. I mean, it's not. You know, football is not just an isolated thing. It's a position. You learn to play with guys. You're going to get a feel for the flow of a game, whether you're on offense or defense.
We play hard today, and we're going to play hard next week. And then that's where you really see what kind of team you have.
If we're not where we ought to be, we're close. Let me put it that way, all right?
Through their first three games, Penn State was used to dealing out the punishment. But in their first Big Ten brawl against Northwestern, it was the Nittany Lions who took the first punch in the mouth, and then some. Even the bounces weren't friendly. But they would answer the bell.
Long and deep downfield. He's got King. Touchdown, Penn State.
For Penn State, this was a classic case for taking one step forward, only to fall two steps back. Still, they didn't quit until the progress favored them.
In front, 50, 45, 40, Justin to the 30, 25, 20, 15, that's inside.
Comebacks like this don't happen without trench warriors like Levi Brown throwing devastating blocks. Yet just when they thought they had come all the way back, the game started to slip away again, like sand through their fingers.
Game is in the hands now of this Penn State offense. Down by two, 29-27 with 2:10 to go.
Got to get to the 31-yard line for the first down on this fourth down play, or the game is over.
Joe Paterno had been through a million of these, but this was a first for a lot of his players. How would they get through it? Isaac Smolko got by telling Michael Robinson he'd get open for him on fourth down and game. Then suddenly, when it seemed they had been running uphill all day, their hard work caused the slope to change.
To get something here. Third down, six, Northwestern 36. Here comes the blitz. Robinson delivers downfield for Derek Williams, wide open at the 10. Derek heads inside to the 5. Touchdown, Penn State.
We have confidence in ourselves. We believe in ourselves. You know, we know that when a game comes down to the wire, you know we can win it. We know we can win big games on the road now, and I just think, you know, we can carry this confidence over to the rest of the season and keep going.
We're trying to get back on top, and we still got a lot of work to do. You can see it in the first half, but we're growing. We're still young. The skill position is still young, and older guys are really pulling us through, and it just helps to have a quarterback like Mike Robinson that can just stay as composed as he did when everything was going wrong. And that one time through the whole game, was he rattled at all?
I just heard our crowd.
Oh, we knew where the noise was.
Yeah. We had just as many fans as they did out there. So
it was a big win. I mean, now we got to look for Minnesota. It's behind. This game is behind us. We take it again, one game at a time. We'll go back home and prepare for Minnesota.
We got Minnesota, man. That game over, man.
For Penn State, the challenges grow stronger each week. This one came from undefeated Minnesota, the best rushing team in the country. And at the end of one particular run came the hit that defined the game and the attitude of the 2005 Nittany Lions. X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya, X gon' give it to ya, he gon' give it to ya. Michael Robinson has led Penn State with his arm, but against Minnesota, it was no match for his legs or his shoulder. He used them all to help keep the Lions unbeaten. He had a whole lot of help.
Pop Robinson lobs it for Butler, near side, 30-yard line. Plays out and makes the catch at the 25. Williams and Golden, near side, Butler, far side. Robinson pitches it back to Williams. He's got Rush in front to the 5. Touchdown, Penn State!
Bradley came in here facing the number one rushing team, you know, in the conference.
The talk had been about Minnesota's offensive line. But Penn State's defense knows action speaks louder than words.
Levi Brown just sort of sealed that side form, and Tony said, hey, I don't even see a gopher around.
Did you see that formation that Joe Paterno used inside the 5-yard line on first down?
Touchdown, Penn State! Option play, King on the reverse. They've got Minnesota set up. 30, 25, 20, King to the...
Nittany Lions of Penn State, as impressive as we've seen them in a long, long time.
Touchdown, Penn State! Rodney Kinlaw for 9 yards out.
And after Penn State rose to meet this latest challenge, the sun set on a very happy valley.
I thought we played a good football game, everywhere.
Once again, you got to give credit to our offense. You know, when they're holding the ball like they're holding it, and we're getting three and outs, now we're rested and we're ready to go. And against a big physical group like that, they wear you down. Well, today we had a lot left in our tank at the end of the game.
I said it before, man. It's Old State now. It's Old State now.
Last Sunday, a huge group of the student body here at Penn State decided they just didn't want tickets. They wanted to be in the front row for Ohio State Penn State. So they set up a tent village just outside Beaver Stadium to make sure they got the best tickets available. It's a new town in Pennsylvania called Paternoville. Live from Penn State.
I have seen Paternoville. I have seen these students. There is nothing like this in the country.
Can't believe it. You really sleeping in these things?
Yeah. It's surreal.
This big border, Big Ten showdown in front of 108,000 folks in here tonight and ESPN's primetime cameras.
This team is eager. These fans are eager. Ohio State has their hands full tonight in Happy Valley. Okay.
It's a big game in a lot of different ways for a lot of different people. I've tried to approach it with the idea it's another football game for us. Realize we're playing one of the best football teams we've ever played against. And I want them to pay attention to details in practice. I want them to pay attention to little things that are going to make the difference in the football game if we have a chance to win it. Just go at it that way and practice hard, practice well, go out and have a little fun. This is just a great situation for a kid who really enjoys big-time football.
These folks have waited in the rain for this moment. The Ohio State University against the Pennsylvania State University. It's a night built for defense. Should be rainy all night. It's windy. 14 straight for the higher-ranked team. Ohio State, number 6. Penn State, number 16.
It's rare that a game can live up to the kind of hype that surrounded the 21st meeting between Penn State and Ohio State. It was only early October, but this one essentially decided the Big Ten title. And the Buckeyes started well.
That kick is good. Ohio State gets on the board first.
But the Nittany Lions calmed the anxiety of nearly 110,000 people, proving they were indeed ready for prime time.
Robinson play action fake. Pressure from the backside. Steps away. 30. Robinson far side 25. First down 20. For 15. Williams gets the toss. Behind Richardson. To the 10. To the 5. Touchdown. Penn State.
I'll tell you, this place is going crazy.
I'm not kidding, this is so hot. I was a quarterback at Iowa State. Right?
clock at 2. At the goal line, Smith calls a timeout. The crowd created that.
The maestro was in command, and his orchestra performed symphony music that soothed the savage beast that was Ohio State's offense.
Down the middle, intercepted. Lowry 30, 25, 20. Lowry 15, 10, to the 5. The Nittany Lions on the doorstep. An option play near side to the goal line. Michael Robinson, touchdown, Penn State.
Even those who have held season tickets for decades couldn't recall a rowdier, more deafening crowd at Beaver Stadium. Spoiled by years of unparalleled success, they were hungry again, and so were the Lions.
Draw play, Tony Hunt, 40, 45, 50, first down.
A perfect call against that blitz.
Good snap, put down, the kick by Kelly is on its way, and that kick is gone! The freshman, Kevin Kelly, comes through.
The love affair between this team and its extended family in the stands was torrid as the Nittany Lions reestablished themselves as the team to beat at the top of the Big Ten. It was Penn State's night. It was New Year's Eve. It was Mardi Gras. It was a very happy valley.
The wildest atmosphere in the country is here at Penn State.
Man, it's a great feeling, but right now I just know that we got to take it game by game.
Students came out and supported us. The crowd came out and supported us. They were, you know, I think Ohio State was forced to use some timeouts that they didn't want to use.
It was a great win. It was a great crowd and great fan support. Boy, it was one of those great nights. You know, you always, I think, with my time here, I can look back and you get the Nebraska game and that Miami game in 86. They're just games you'll remember, and I'll remember this game.
People want to know if Penn State is back. What would you say?
Oh, I don't know whether we ever left.
On the field, I can run for days.
This will be a really tough challenge for us against a good football team. Michigan's you know, it's a very challenging place to play. I don't think we're a great football team. I think we're getting better all the time. And I think each one of these different opportunities to adjust, to handle different situations, crowds, different types of personnel, those kinds of things, determine how good you're going to get to be. So I we're looking forward to it, but we're not naive. This is going to be a tough, tough football game. A big-time football game. They're a good football team. We just got to play as well as we can play and see what happens.
Tony Hunt, right side, 40, Tony, 45, 50, 45, 40, 35, 30, 25, 20, 15 to the 10 to the 5, inside the 5, and finally knocked out at the 2-yard line. Robinson under center, back to pass, short shot, quarterback draw, to the goal line, touchdown, Penn State! And a blitz coming, and he steps up and gets away. 30, 35, stood up, takes it away. 25, 20, 15 to the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Penn State. The Nittany Lions dramatically take the lead. Alan Zamaitis took the ball away and runs it in for a score. Kick is up, nothing. Goal was left out. Kelly's going to try and run it for 2 points. Kelly to the goal line. He's got the 2 points. Kevin Kelly, the place kicker, runs it in for two.
There were heroes everywhere for the Nittany Lions. Circumstances allowed it, as well as one of the best fourth quarter drives in Penn State history.
Back to pass, time, throws it up down the middle. Norwood makes a tough catch at the 45 to the 42 of Michigan, and a first down for Penn State.
Just like the road win at Northwestern, Michael Robinson converted on fourth down and game, and then went one better.
58 seconds left. Robinson back to pass. He'll run it. Mike to the right, to the goal line. Touchdown, Penn State! And in the clutch, the Nittany Lions deliver again.
This was a nearly impossible feat. 81 yards in 13 plays with no timeouts in less than 2 minutes. A perfect drive that would have been celebrated for years had Michigan not countered. Maybe the Wolverines would have scored anyway, but the murkiness of a missed call will keep that a mystery forever.
line. He gets out of there.
He's out of bounds.
This is an out-of-bounds play, and I'll tell you right now, they're going to have to review this.
He's out of bounds.
Well, that was his foot came down on the line.
He was out of bounds. He is out. They've got to stop this.
They're not going to. They're going to get the play off.
Like two gunslingers fighting to the end, both Michigan and Penn State refused to blink. But the Wolverines had one more bullet, leaving the Nittany Lions tied for the Big Ten lead.
It was a heck of a football game. It's a game you'd like to win, but it was a very, very good football game. Played by two teams who were very determined to win it, and two quarterbacks who played very well. You know, we all came into this year figuring, hey, we got something to prove, and we joined hands, and, we've got a ways to go yet, but they've just been guys they've been easy to coach, and I like to be around them.
We can't be worried about other teams and their situations and things like that. We figure if we do the little things, if we keep focusing and keep taking care of our business, things will go in our favor.
Robinson back to pass. What's coming is picked up over the middle. He's got Keller 30, 25, far side 20, 15. He's into the 10 to the 5. Touchdown, Penn State, as Ethan Kilmer turned on the speed and scored. And back goes Robinson. Blitz picked up. Fires wide open. Butler at the 10 to 5. Touchdown, Penn State.
He gets better all the time. I think that's probably about as consistent as he's been all year. He read things well, picked out a couple open guys, got rid of the ball in a hurry, because he he can run.
Now, I think Michael Rogers feels it right now that he could put up some serious numbers here throwing the football.
Robinson has a man, touchdown, Deion Butler.
Robinson back to pass, throws in the end zone, wide open, Patrick Hall, touchdown, Penn State, four touchdown passes in the first quarter for Michael Robinson. Back goes Brasek, steps up, Dan fumbles the football, loose on the turf, Connor picks it up at the 15, the 10, the 5, touchdown, Penn State, Dan Connor.
Look out! Oh boy, Brasek gets flattened from behind by Tom Ali. Touchdown! Nice block by Brandon Snow, the fullback.
Touchdown, Penn State. Intercepted McCready, 25-30. Touchdown, Penn State. Nolan McCready, a 75-yard interception return. Pressure from A.Q. Shipley, who gets his first career sack at the 1-yard line.
The Illini down by 60. And it's going to give Joe Paterno win number 350 of his career tonight. Also off to their best start since 1999.
Penn State is 7-1 on the season. They defeat Illinois at Memorial Stadium in Champaign tonight, 63-10.
You know, we've had some tough games these past couple of weeks, emotional games, close games. So, we just wanted to go out and play as well as we possibly could. You know, things ended up going our way, so we got a chance to get some younger guys in the game, get them some experience.
Did I know it was my 350th win? No. It's nice to hear, though.
Three games left, you've got a share of the lead. What would it mean to you to be able to finish this out and win a Big Ten championship?
I'm worried about Purdue, period. One game at a time. I mean, that's been my life, not only as far as football goes, everything that's in my life. As I said, let's take care of the little things first, the big things will take care of themselves, to what you got to do this week, and then we'll take care of what we got to do next week. I've never felt I had the luxury of being able to go beyond that. So when you talk about what goes on after we play Purdue, I don't know. Now, honest to goodness, And I know sometimes you say, he's full of baloney. But I'm telling you, the only thing I'm worried about right now is whether we can beat Purdue.
A mixture of Halloween and homecoming made for great atmosphere, but the real excitement in the crisp autumn air was over a football team that was ninth in the BCS poll. These Nittany Lions were not masquerading, but the real deal, as they got set to play a Purdue team that had been ranked as high as 10th in the country. But things didn't start according to plan.
And here comes Painter. Painter keeping it for the end zone. They didn't account for him. Touchdown, Purdue!
Yet on a team that's been characterized by its freshman stars, the senior leadership is as strong as it's ever been. With heart as big as it's ever been. Players like Ethan Kilmer rarely get headlines, but always get their man on kick coverage.
Melvin takes it at the 32. Melvin, who was left 35, and down he goes at the 48. Bubbles a football. Penn State's around, and Penn State recovers. Will the Lions come up with a big special teams play?
Easy Smith may have come up with that football.
He did.
Then there are the reluctant heroes, the strong, silent types like Tony Hunt, emerging from the shadows, separating himself from other Big Ten running backs. He is old school in a new age Penn State offense, preferring to let his legs do the talking. And they were screaming on Saturday.
Gives the ball to Tony Hunt. Hunt barrels head over the 40, 45, breaks the tackle, 50, 45, inside the 45 to the 42-yard line.
While leaves fell from the trees outside the stadium, fans rose to their feet inside, celebrating another Golden Autumn afternoon and Penn State win in Happy Valley. And while Hunt piled up yardage, he was happy for his fullback, Brandon Snow, who scored the first two touchdowns of his career. A kind of Nittany unselfishness that permeates this team from the top on down.
I think this year we took on a new attitude approach. We have great leaders in Mike Allen and Puzlesny, guys that are, you know, they don't really dwell on the past too much. As you can see, you know, we had a tough break at Michigan, but we rebounded and we're on the right track right now.
They've been great bunch of kids to coach. They've been, you know, and I didn't expect them to fold. I expected them to do just what they've done.
Oh, I mean, the fans are unbelievable so far this season. I mean, they fuel us. They fuel us. They make us play better.
That's one thing about playing for Penn State. We always know that we have very special fans. They're always going to be here to support us. They're going to be loud, and you know, it's great playing in front of them.
Doing all right, man. Got a lot of emotion going on right now. So I'm gonna miss the atmosphere, the fans, man. I'm gonna miss everything. So I'm just trying to soak it all in right now.
Paterno has watched a lot of seniors play their final home game, but perhaps none had endured what this year's seniors had.
Rolls near side, one stop, long and deep, Deion Butler at the goal line, touchdown, Penn State!
Their struggles and return to national prominence made this year all the sweeter, a testimony to their perseverance.
Back goes Robinson. Draw play to Hunt to the 10, to the 5. Tony, touchdown. Penn State in the end zone. Intercepted. Alan Tobias picked it off.
Backed by a fan base that never left them and a coaching staff that was as diligent as they were, Penn State took on Wisconsin with a top spot in the Big Ten up for grabs.
goes Stocko. Here comes Alford. Here comes Matthew White. And down he goes.
All of them, but especially the seniors, were not about to let this opportunity slip past.
Guys that the NFL drools after because he plays hard every play.
As did all of the Nittany Lions as they shut down one of the best offenses in the country. While their own offense continued to produce at a record-setting pace.
To the right, to the 10, to the 5, touchdown, Penn State! Game, set, match, first place Nittany Lions.
Walking out of the tunnel one final time was tough enough for the seniors. Walking back in would have been even more difficult if there wasn't so much left to play for.
They worked as hard as any team I've ever had. And you like to see that pay off.
Hey, way to put something together, baby. That's how we run the ball.
The greatest feeling I've ever had, you know, played Nebraska, played Ohio State this year, and, you know, being able to run out on that field, just to feel all those people cheering for you when you run out and being introduced as a senior, and then the way we played today, we played a really solid football game, and, you know, it's the greatest feeling I've probably had in a long time.
I think, the turning point for this team wasn't this year, it was last year.
After that game?
It was after Indiana, that goal line stand.
So it means the world to us because, you know, you see these kids and they bust their tails and they go after it every day in practice and you want them to get the payoff and they're getting the payoff now.
They stuck together, and they're in the middle of a pretty good year.
One game away, Coach.
Well, it's still one game.
Thanks.
Thanks. We got to go out there, and we got to practice well, stay healthy, be rested, go out and understand we're going to be in a really tough football game against a team that comes from a tradition with a lot of pride, well-coached, great athletes, and we have to go to work. I mean, that's simple as that. We can't turn it over. We got to be careful with the kicking game. We can't give up big plays. Most of the things you got to do to win a big football game. We got a big football game on our hands, period. They want to go to a bowl bid, and we want to win the Big Ten championships. What are you going to do?
Since they were little kids, every practice, every scrimmage and meeting was about getting this opportunity to play for a championship. So was every daydream. But now that a championship was a win away, Penn State had prepared them to treat it no differently.
Just a regular game, no pitch, yeah, regular game. So we gotta look at it.
But deep down inside, they knew it was more than that. And they played like it.
Stand back to pass. Pressure over the middle. Intercepted. The Nittany Lions get a turnover at the 1-yard line. Back goes spin. Pressure. Down it goes. Jason Alford at the 23-yard line.
It wasn't the most crisp of games, but Hart made up for that.
Here they come. Donnie Johnson blocked it. Russell Mateo, touchdown, Penn State.
Their coach had been through it when the stakes were even higher, that he was glad to lead a new group to unexpected heights. As night fell, so did the bowl hopes of Michigan State with yet another Michael Robinson run.
Robinson back to pass, puts on the outside, steps away, 35, Mike cuts up 30, 25 to the 20, Robinson far side, 15 to the 10 to the 5, touchdown Penn State! Throws in the end zone, it's intercepted! Donnie Johnson picks it off of the Nittany Lions, and the Penn State defense comes up big again!
Tough throw, intercepted Zomaitis. Look at him, he might take it. Picking up blocks, Allen Zomaitis gets to the 15.
Robinson back to pass. Waits, he throws in the end zone. Touchdown, Penn State, Deion Butler. The field now throws downfield. It is intercepted. Allen Zomaitis again, his third interception of the game. That's it. The Nittany Lions are Big Ten champions and BCS bound.
Thousands traveled with them to share the achievement, the bliss that was extraordinary, because this group had been through so much. A championship is sweetened by how far you have to go to get it, and this team traveled quite a distance. Space and time permanently added to the proud tradition of the ongoing Penn State football story.
Proving that we out here getting this trophy and getting this Big Ten title. That's what it's all about, man. With all these guys, it's all family.
All we've been through as a program, you know, just to be able to be on top as a finish, I mean, it's great. A lot of emotion going on, man.
It's very important. That's what we came here to do. We came here to play in games like this. We came here to, you know, win games like this. And, you know, the fans have been great all year long. All the true Penn State fans have stayed supporting us. And, like I said, we're just happy that everything went our way today.
Penn State, they fall to 0-6 in the Big Ten.
After losing to Northwestern in the ninth game of the 2004 season, Penn State was all alone in last place of the Big Ten. That Monday, Joe Paterno canceled practice and read Shakespeare's Hamlet to his team. To be or not to be, that is the question. Whether 'tis nobler in the mind to suffer the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune, or to take arms against a sea of troubles and end them. Just their third win, and yet the faithful remained.
Delivers down the middle, and intercepted. Pazuzzi, 25, Paul to the 20. Pazuzzi near side, 15, to the 10-yard line. Will Robinson near corner, Mike in the air. Touchdown, Penn State!
Joe Paterno and Penn State had suffered the slings and arrows of outrageous fortune throughout his career. But now, Penn State, Joe Paterno and his seniors, who had known tough times, had a new challenge to take arms against a sea of troubles and by opposing end them. I'm not interested in winning six or seven games and going to a bowl, said Paterno. I want to win them all. We can shock the world. It was time to be or not to be Penn State.
Welcome back to Beaver Stadium on an absolutely beautiful day as the Nittany Lion football team gets ready to open the season against the Bulls of South Florida. Williams, flip it back in the reverse to Justin King, near side 30, King 35, 40, King 45, 50, 45, 40, near side 35, 30, and then Belton and fumbles the football, Allen's minus to the 10 to the 5, touchdown Penn State. Tim Shaw forced the fumble, and Allen Zamitis takes it to the house.
And Michael Robinson using the pass game, set long and deep for Deion Butler, near side. Deion at the goal line. He's got it. Touchdown, Penn State.
Trust formed on the practice field fueled their belief, while those outside of the program waited to see if the Nittany Lions would buckle. The answer was found in the last minutes at Northwestern, as two plays would help define a season.
Fourth down, 15, their own 15. They need the 30 to keep this game alive. Good snap, back goes Robinson. Klein steps up, over the middle for Spoko. First down, 35-yard line. Robinson balls it out. Good snap, here comes the blitz. Robinson delivers downfield for Derek Williams, wide open at the 10. Derek cuts inside to the 5, touchdown, Penn State.
It was apparent that this was a new team. A new confidence was born. The belief of a few seniors became the passion of the Penn State Nation, and the world watched as Beaver Stadium became the greatest show in college football.
Robinson, option play near side, to the goal line, Michael Robinson, touchdown, Penn State! Smith back to pass. Pressure. Down he goes. Tom Holley fumbles the football. Penn State recovers. Snap action. The Nittany Lions defense comes up with the signature play of this game.
The faithful were rewarded, and their bond became permanent. The race to a championship was on and a place in history imminent. Came down to one game for a championship and to completely restore the pride.
Mike cuts up 30, 25, to the 20, round to the 5, by 15, to the 10, to the 5, touchdown Penn State!
This team, led by unyielding seniors, took up arms and by so opposing the seas of troubles, ended them.
Has begun.